Hello friends, it's Angelina and Dima from Work Energy World. It's our day 4 of GR11.
And we had a bit of a planning time yesterday, having a hard time to plan our trail ahead because now we're going a little bit behind our initial plan because yesterday we stopped like several kilometers before because we were so tired and exhausted from the heat. So now we have to kind of divide it into several days so that we can compensate it slowly. So for the day we decided to do 8 kilometers to the village Encamp, which is one of the major villages we're going to be passing. Gonna do our shopping there, resupply a lot of food, and this way gonna be mostly downhill, so it's gonna be around 500 meters down. And then we plan to do the uphill, which is gonna be a major one, around 1000 meters, what the map says is true. So for the uphill we plan to do around 7 kilometers out of the village, and there we hope to stay tonight. So we'll see how it goes. No exact plan really. We hope that the weather will work in our favor today, and yeah, let's start the day.
It's 8 a.m. now and we're out on the trail. We had a good night in a quiet forest. We heard only the roe deer sounds at night and in the morning. It was the warmest night out of three. It was very comfortable to sleep.
First several kilometers is done. We didn't notice how we've done this downhill in around like 40 minutes or so. And now we have a little bit of an uphill to tackle before downhill to the village Encamp. We think it won't be too difficult and too long. So up we go.
uphill wasn't too difficult and long, fortunately, and we're still enjoying the route in the shadow, which is very nice.
We hope it continues the same way and we'll be in the shadow all day long. Such a lovely forest we are walking in right now. There is very easy walking path. Also, there is quite a bit of people here, but it is so lovely. We're passing by the lake Engolasters, I think it's called, and we see on the info boards that it is used for hydroelectric power, as many of the lakes actually in the region, Pyrenees. It looks quite beautiful, but it is not natural, fortunately. This downhill leading to Encamp is obviously much more challenging and steeper. You have to skip over the rocks and roots than it was before what we've done. So yeah, but we are almost there. So we spent a little bit of time here in Encamp, went for shopping, resupplied a lot of stuff like cheese, bread and all the essentials, and now we have to go uphill, but you guys, we don't want to do it now because it's like the hottest time of the day. It's 2 p.m. now. We don't know what to do because normally we are already setting our camp at this hour and just going to rest. We prefer this scenario, but today is obviously not happening, and we'll try their best to do the uphill, but I don't know how much we can survive because we feel like it's even hotter today than yesterday. It's like 30 plus degrees Celsius in the sun. Just hope for the shadow. If it's gonna be the shadow path, we're gonna be able to do it.
So we are on a middle day break. Decided to stop in the shadow close to the river because when we started going uphill, we realized we can be hit by the sun because it's super, super strong now. It's 2 p.m. in the afternoon and it's the strongest phase of sun angle.
Also looking at the Google Earth map, we realized that all the uphill would be almost with no shadow because unfortunately this mountain is not covered in trees almost. Only at the top you got some of the shadow. So yeah, so we think that it's better to be safe than sorry after. So today it's gonna be a little bit of different pace of hiking. So we'll have our middle day break and then continue on hiking for around 2 hours more, I think. Hopefully find a place to camp up there. Enjoying our time here, our siesta time. We're back on the trail again. It's 16 p.m. right now. The sun is a bit lower, but still quite high on the horizon. And we can see now getting higher, the mountain where we came from, this one. two like antennas or something. We came down to the village camp. Now we're on the way up to the other mountain. Oh, right here, very hot. This part of the way that we're tackling now is very reminiscent to us, actually, to the Camino de San Jaume that we've done, I think 2 years ago. It was our first Camino, which was only like 7 days long. But it was an epic one because of the heat, because it was very, very hot. And now we're kind of much higher in the mountains, but it still doesn't help. We're kind of in the same region where we've been on that Camino, so we think it influences as well. But maybe it's just this hot summer season, late July. Finally on top of this uphill that is called like the hill, but we felt it a lot. It was very, very challenging, you guys. Just like, or it's very hot weather, don't know really the reason, but we're absolutely killed right now. And now we just want to get to the water source and search for our camp there. And well, what we can say about this Coll d'Ordino leading to Encamp or out of it is that better you do it like in the first hour in the morning or late in the evening, but you know, it's not realistic when you're doing a long distance hiking, so it's better to do early in the morning if you can, of course. In our case it was just inevitable, but we would escape it if we could. So this is our tip for you. Here on this plateau there are endless possible places to camp, but unfortunately there is no water, no creek, no river, and we don't hear any. This is such a pity because we would stop here already as we're so tired, but I have to continue on. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment below to let us know how you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more hiking adventures. Don't forget to hit the bell to stay notified about every new video. Also visit our website walkingnatureworld.com to find detailed hike reports with pictures and maps. Have a beautiful day, everybody, and until very soon!